Was the Nuremberg Toy Show just huge, as you can see here from what's on the bench. And this isn't everything. We have a lot of new releases to talk about. So let's get started here with On the Horizon for this week. First of all, you guys have seen us tease it. We did it on last show. You can listen to David Payne on the RC cast from last week talking about it. We've teased it. You guys have asked for it. We are here to talk to you about the new MiG from E-flite. It's an ultra micro size EDF, and this is something David has really worked hard on. Again, if you haven't heard it yet, make sure that you go back and listen to last week's RC cast, which we'll link down in the more info section. But we caught up with David to learn even more about this exciting new ultra micro electric ducted fan jet. David, take it away.
Hi, I'm David Payne from E-flite Product Development, and we're here today with the new UMX MiG 15. It's our first release of the, you know, a ducted fan jet for the UMX market. MiG 15, very popular, iconic war jet, and we're very happy with it. You know, it's we tried to make a jet that was very scale. We wanted to keep very close scale outline, and we wanted to make sure that it still looked like a jet when we were done with it. So we worked really hard to do a lot of intake and exhaust design to make sure that we kept the scale outline. There's no cheater holes on the jet, as you can see. It's very clean. The jet is a very good performer. It has AS3X technology built into it, so with AS3X it gives it a huge wide speed range and envelope. You know, it's very happy at high speeds, but it's also very stable and very well controlled at slow speeds. Handles outdoor weather extremely well, you know, winds, whatever you kind of you can think of, you can fly it very, very good and very well in park situations or windy conditions, anything like that. As you see there, there's a lot of details as far as panel lines and hatch detail and things of that nature. We've got an authentic scale trim scheme on it. We've got little cannons, simulated cannons on it. The nose gear is steerable, so you know, any kind of taxiing or things of that nature you can do, but also they're very easy to remove, so you can go and hand launch and fly around that way if you want to also. The airplane is four channel. It's got a fully, it's a semi-symmetrical wing, so it's not an under-camber wing. So, you know, we're not kind of reducing any speed there either, kind of trying to take care of the speed demon side of the ultra-micro world. But we're super excited. It's got a scale working rudder, so both the top and the bottom, like the real MiG, work just like the real one. It's got a new fan unit in it, the Delta V180M, which is designed very similar and kind of a lot of the same features and benefits as our larger Delta V fan units. As you can see, it bolts right in. It's not like a glue-in application or anything like that. It's easily accessible if you need to replace anything or things of that nature. A little 10 millimeter end runner, brushless end runner on it with a 28 millimeter fan unit. So one of the smallest fan units I think there is on the market right now, and it's working very well. It performs very well and does a great job. You know, the battery in the MiG is the 2S200, which has already came out in our GB and our Ultra Micro Striker, so many of you may already have that battery and will be able to use it in the MiG. You get flight times, you know, full power. If you don't use the throttle at all, you're going to look at about a 3.5 minute flight or so, and if you manage the throttle easily, like a 5-6 minute flight, just depending on how you're flying and what you're doing. As I said before, it's great. The MiG is a lot of fun to fly full power and just scream around, but it's also very interesting to watch. You can watch our other product video on Horizon Hobby. You can watch the slow speed characteristics are amazing with this airplane. You know, it'll fly very stable and very slow and be very friendly to you. So you might want to explore that too. It's actually another good side to explore with the airplane. The airplane is same price as our other AS3X airplanes. It's $169.99. And it comes bind and fly ready, so you'll get what you see here, your charger, your battery, and the airplane ready to go. AS3X technology out of the box, it's ready to go. There's no dual rates, no expo needed, just bind it to your favorite transmitter and go enjoy yourself. The airplane is going to be due right around the spring time frame, and we're really looking forward to getting it out there to you and seeing you enjoy the jet side of the Ultra Micros.
Man, I tell you, I've had a chance to see this thing fly. That MiG is ridiculous how awesome it is. I can't wait to get my hands on one of those and fly it myself. Should be really, really cool. And look for more information from both David and John Redman coming up very soon on the MiG Ultra Micro Size from E-flite. Shifting away from E-flite for a moment, we have a new plane from HobbyZone. And that's this guy here. This is the Firebird Stratos from HobbyZone. And it's a new teach yourself to fly airplane from this guy here. I don't know if you guys can see it or not. That's Kike Somanzini is the man who has brought this Stratos to life. It's just, it's a great looking plane. And the more I talked to him about it and learned about it, the more interested in this plane, even me, I became. So we caught up with Kike Somanzini to find out about the Firebird Stratos from HobbyZone.
Hi there. I'm here with our new trainer from HobbyZone, Firebird Stratos. And I would like to tell you a little bit about the airplane and how we, you know, how's our thinking behind this design. First, I will kind of walk you through from outside to the inside. So let me start first, you know, why is a twin? That will be a question. The twin is, the main purpose of the twin is first, it would have a very good protection in case of a crash. You know, the plane goes in, the motors are, and the propellers are protected by the front end of the airplane. The propellers turns counter-rotated, so they go in one direction, they're propagated the other direction, so it's canceling what is called torque. For beginners, the explanation of that is no matter the plane attitude and the throttle setting, the plane will go straight. That's important. Make it easier for the pilot. And the other reason is it uses the thrust of each of these motors to turn, to make turns. So it's a combination of the rudder and the differential of thrust between the motors that will make it to turn. And that's very important. The reason is when we fly model airplanes, we fly ground speed. What means ground speed? Means that our sense of speed is through how we see our airplane moving through the air and taking reference our the ground. So if we have some wind, we're flying the airplane a lot faster going into the wind than coming downwind. So what means that? Well, if you are learning to fly, you want the airplane to be very easy to handle and respond, you know, soft, but at the same time have a good response to the control. So one of the struggles is when you have like a single motor or no differential thrust, you're going into the wind, the plane is very sensitive, and then coming downwind, the plane is very lazy and sometimes even doesn't want to turn. So in this case, using the motors where the propellers are totally independent from the air, it will make the airplane to turn very similar way downwind than into the wind. So as a result of that, the plane it has much better handling. Then another aspect of the design is the wing shape. You can see here from the back. It's a very complex wing. It has a different type of airfoil across from the middle to the root. So this allows the wing, the plane to fly in a very, very stable at any speed, and especially the stall characteristic is very, very straight, not tip stall and that kind of things. And the other aspect of the design, as you see in it, is a very sleek look, kind of making the plane very attractive for those that go and fly, you know, get excited about flying the airplane because it looks nice. I think that's an important part of this. It's a fantasy airplane. Mirko Pecorari from Aircraft Studio in Italy helped me with the shape of this, and George Hicks, the other side, helped me with the design of the wing. So it's kind of the three men working together here. Then other features important are the nose. It's a rubber nose. This is important for hard landings, I call. And then the wing is detachable. So in case of a car wheel, the wing will detach from the airplane in a very, very easy way, like you see here. It's supported by magnet, and then it has this pin in the top to firmly secure the airplane and the wing to the airplane. And so this other important thing is a Z-foam, so it can be repaired and glued with any kind of glue. Then the electronics on board on the airplane is very complex, but I think it's a well thought and a totally designed to support the best, to have a great flying experience from day one. We have on board what we call the virtual instructor. The virtual instructor has four elements. So the first one is the wing level. So it helps. It has a sensor on board that it will detect wing level. If the plane is off, just stick to the center, and the plane basically will come back to wing level slowly. Come back and back to a level flight. The other is what is called reduced rate or bank limiter. So the plane will tolerate, some kind of bank, but when you exceed a bank that it put the airplane in the danger or a complicated situation, it will stop and it will limit that bank and will reduce that risk of having spirals, coming a spiral down the airplane. That is a very popular way to, crash airplanes when you're learning to fly. So the virtual instructor part of the virtual instructor, we have two mixes. One is throttle. The throttle is linked to the rudder or the steering system. So if you give some right or left rudder for turns, it will also automatically put some up elevator to keep the turns flat. The other one will be it is the throttle. When it crosses 50% down in power, the plane has to slow down. The elevator will pull up to keep the nose up, helping big time for landings. And as I explained before, this wing level system is also tied to the motors. So the corrections to take back to level are also executed by the two motors. So the corrections comes faster. So the plane is done an engineer in mind to, you take this plane by yourself, take it out of the box, go to the field, read well the manual, and we're confident you will have a very good success from day one. It can fly, so we suggest without the gear, very easy to remove. That would be the first flights. It has a little dent here, so we put the fingers for a good launch. And as you learn to fly, then it's a second stage. The virtual instructor can be turned off. So then the pilot can test how it's flying by itself. Also the elevator, it can be joined here by two pieces of tape, and then the complete elevator comes and operate, which makes the airplane, almost you can do some basic aerobatic, and of course put back the landing gear and do touch and goes and things like that. The plane is a guy by a 2.4 radio, and very good range, which is important for beginners. The map price is $129.99. As you see, for the size and all the features I describe, it's a very, very good price. And the battery on board, it comes with a battery, the charger. This is RTF, so it's transmitter, charger, battery on the airplane. And the battery is a LiPo, it's a 2S, and it's 1300 milliamperes. So I hope you guys like it. I'm very excited about Firebird Stratos. Looking forward to see a lot of them in the field.
Thanks a lot, Kike. And I, for one, am really excited about this Firebird Stratos. It's a great looking fantasy type plane. It has a lot of neat details that have gone into it. And the fact that virtual instructor, man, it's just, it is never been easier to get your feet wet and to get up and fly in the world of radio-controlled airplanes, as it is right now, thanks to planes like the Firebird Stratos from HobbyZone. Now, talking about getting your feet wet, you can see here we have a new sailboat from ProBoat Models. And this is the Westward 18. As you can see, it's a rather small boat designed for, well, smaller areas. One of the cool things about this boat here is it comes out of the box pretty much as you see it here. All you have to do is attach the keel and you're ready to go out and have fun. You'll need to add some AA batteries and things along those lines to finish the boat out, but it comes complete out of the box for you as you see it here. It's got the nice stand on it. Even includes a Spektrum DX2M marine capable transmitter right out of the box. Very nice, leisurely, and casual way to get out there into the world of RC sailboating. Now, if you are a beginner, perfect for you guys, but if you do have some boating experience, that always helps. Now, talking about sailing and sailboats, you might also notice we have a little sailplane here too. This is the ASK-21, and this is a pretty cool little plane. It's an ultra-micro sailplane that you use in conjunction with the Carbon Cub, as you see here. Seth Arnold is the man who has been working on both of these planes to bring them out to you, along with an ultra micro Spitfire. Yeah, you guys out there, there's a couple of you out there, you know, Ian, this is just for you out there. The ultra micro Spitfire from Park Zone. We have these two planes here from E-flite. Let's see what Seth has to say about all three of these great planes that he has that debuted at Nuremberg.
Hi guys, I'm Seth Arnold with Horizon Hobby here to show you two new cool airplanes from E-flite. We'll start off talking a little bit about the first one, the ultra micro Carbon Cub and the UMX line airplanes. It's a really, really cool airplane. It's five channel, so it comes with flaps out of the box installed. You don't have to do anything there, but also comes with a light set already installed, and also an optional float set. So it's a really cool airplane. Comes in a bind and fly package. We're talking probably into March, early April for the time frame on this particular airplane. But the really, really cool thing with this is the towing experience you can get with the Ultra Micro ASK-21. So it actually comes with a tow attachment you can attach up on to the top of the fuselage of the airplane and tow the ASK up into the air. Also new for E-flite is the Ultra Micro ASK-21, which is a really cool airplane in itself to even have a sailplane in this size. You know, there's a lot of giant scale sailplanes out there. They're a lot of fun to fly, but you know, they're pretty expensive, and it's kind of hard to get that sailplane experience. So what we've done is offered an ultra micro sailplane, which makes it much more accessible to a lot of people out there and to get that full experience. But the cool thing is, not only can you tow it with a Carbon Cub, but it also comes with the high start included, so you don't have to have a buddy tow your airplane up in the air or that kind of thing. You can actually fly it on your own or go slope soaring. It's actually very easy to slope soar, but it's a very cool airplane in itself. This airplane actually comes with AS3X as well as the Cub. So you get a really, really stable flight on the high start on tow. It makes it very, very enjoyable to fly and just a really cool experience. This airplane also comes as a bind and fly package, and this airplane is going to be coming in available about May. So look for it on the dealer shelves and also on horizonhobby.com. It's a lot of fun. In addition to the two new ultra micro airplanes from E-flite and the UMX line, we also have a very cool airplane in the Park Zone Ultra Micro Series line, kind of a follow-up to the ultra micro Corsair and Mosquito in the Warbird segment. This time it's the ultra micro Spitfire, which is a very cool airplane. But the coolest thing about this is the first ultra micro in Park Zone that has AS3X. So very, very sweet flying airplane, very stable in windy conditions, and just very stable overall. It actually comes with a four-bladed prop, as you can see on the front. Very, very good performing propeller. Comes with the new E-flite 150 milliamp 25C battery. I don't know if some of you guys may have already seen that on shelves with the MSRX, but a very, very good performing battery and a very good flying airplane overall. This airplane will be coming as a bind and fly package, and should be available around June timeframe. So expect to see it then.
Thanks a lot, Seth. Now, one of the things Seth did talk about with the Carbon Cub, and this combined with the ASK-21, gonna be an absolute blast out there. I can see a lot of people getting both of them just so that you can go out and really enjoy the aero towing experience in your local park. But if you remember, Seth also mentioned floats. We've got them. Look at these are so cool. Look at that. And they've just got little, it's just a pressure fit and it goes right into the bottom of the fuselage here. Snap that on, just boom, right off the water. Oh, that'd be really, really fun. I can see just having a blast with these on the water, small ponds, you know, things like that. This little carbon cub with the float set, very cool. Set the lights and everything. Oh man, this thing will be super dialed. Now if you notice, we've kind of cleaned off the bench a little bit. We've brought some new products up. We've set some of the other ones aside. And a lot of folks for a number of years have asked us, why don't you make a Zero? We wish we had a Zero. You guys have got a Mustang, you've had a Focke-Wulf, you've had Spitfires, you've had Trojans, you've had Corsairs. What about a Zero? We got a Zero for you guys right here from E-flite. This is a new Zero that Ryan Smith has been working very hard on. In addition to this plane here, he's also been working on a new Platinum Series Albatross. He's going to join us in just a second here to talk more about each of these two new planes. First, he's going to talk to us about the Albatross from E-flite and then the new Zero.
Hi, my name is Ryan Smith, product developer for E-flite. I'm here today to talk to you about the new E-flite Albatross D5A 25 size Platinum Series. This airplane is modeled after the German World War I fighter, the Albatross D5. It was introduced in late 1913 and saw service there towards the end of the war. As you can see, it's a very pretty airplane. It was one of the most aesthetically pleasing airplanes of World War I, and it also had very advanced construction techniques for its day. Most airplanes had just kind of basic truss style construction, covered in fabric. This airplane, the fuselage, was actually what's called monocoque construction, which is a stress skin construction. It used plywood that was held in shape by formers, so very, very advanced construction for its day. Yielded a very strong, very lightweight structure. So here's the model. It's constructed primarily out of balsa and some light plywood, as most of our wood ARFs are. As every other Platinum Series airplane as well, it's got a high level of detail. You can see up front we've got the motor detail. The full-scale airplane was powered by a Mercedes-Benz inline engine, so it's kind of hard to skip that detail on an airplane like this, especially a Platinum Series airplane. And in the front, you'll also notice it's got a very uniquely shaped spinner that is actually a painted aluminum spinner that is included with the airplane. Because of the shape and the style and the size of the airplane, there's really no off-the-shelf spinner that will work with this airplane. So that is an added bonus that gives you, you know, finishes off the airplane, and that's one less thing for you to have to buy to complete the airplane itself. I think I said it's covered in all ultra coat. The bottom of the wing actually features printed ultra coat and what's called a lozenge pattern. For those of you that have been around the hobby a little while, you may remember the Hangar 9 Fokker D7 from several years ago. The bottom of the wing, if you may remember, had kind of a, looked like a multicolored soccer ball underneath it. And that's a camouflage pattern that was unique to World War I German fighters. So again, this airplane, in order to stay true to its scale roots, we've got that included on the airplane as well, so it makes it look really cool in flight. It's very unique, not something that you see very often. What else? It's got two power plant options, power 25 and power 32. It's got an adjustable motor mount, as does many of our Platinum Series airplanes, most recently the Super Cub 25E. So it has very good performance on either engine. The Power 25 has more of a scale floaty power. The Power 32 obviously is going to give you more power, a little bit better aerobatic capability. Both power plants are using the 60 amp E-flite ESC. The Power 32, we're running a 14.7 prop. Power 25 is 13 by 6.5. 4S 3200 milliamp battery for both setups, similar to the Super Cub 25E. Airplane's got four servos, two mini servos, so like the Spektrum A4010s and MN48s from JR Sport, and then two micro servos for the ailerons. Each aileron has its own servo, so the linkage is hidden fairly well inside the airplane. The rudder and elevator and stabilizer, kind of the tail of the airplane, is actually pre-installed at the factory. So there's no gluing that's involved with this airplane. It's kind of like putting a car or a helicopter together. You just bolt everything on. So, and it even has the hinging done for you. The tail uses brass scale hinges like you would see on the real airplane, and the ailerons have hinge point hinges that have already been glued in with epoxy at the factory. So kind of a unique hinging system with the airplane. The elevator features optional, or has an option for pull-pull controls. So the you use a pull-pull cable, braided wire, instead of using a push rod. What that does is gives you a little bit more finite control of the elevator, and it also mimics the full-scale airplane. So the full-scale airplane had pull-pull controls on the elevator because that was really all that was available at the time. So you kind of get a added benefit, the scale detail and the better control over the airplane. You may see this airplane has the flying wires installed. Airplane will fly without the flying wires if you do not choose to install them. However, they do add a great deal of realism to the airplane and a great deal of strength to the airplane. The full-scale airplane used them because the wings were so thin and just because of the construction techniques of the day. It was necessary actually for them to have those for structural reasons, just like a high wing airplane has struts, or you even see this airplane has the interplane struts. So kind of a added benefit there. This airplane has an optional cockpit kit that's available separately, as well as provisions for putting a pilot in the airplane to kind of give you that last little bit of realism in, with the airplane. You can see the thing on top of the wing right there. It's actually a plastic kind of representation of a radiator, because the airplane, the full-scale airplane's engine was liquid cooled. That was the actual radiator for the airplane. So that's there for you to install if you choose. Fully functioning landing gear, I'm not sure if I mentioned that, just like all of our other 25 size airplane, Platinum Series airplanes. And this one actually has a tail skid that actually is shock absorbing as well. This airplane does have conventional landing gear, but it does not have a tail wheel. It's got a varnished wood tail skid, just like the full-scale airplane. The tail skid is completely varnished and ready to install at the factory. So, you know, I've kind of hinted that a lot of the stuff is factory installed, factory done. They're really, honestly, for this level of detail on an airplane, something like this, if you were to build it from a kit, could take you weeks, could take you months. This airplane can be ready in around 5 hours. It's honestly, for what you get, it's amazing how much prefabrication has gone into it, and it's very accurate, it's very light. Airplane flies fantastic. It is typical of a World War I airplane. It's not an unlimited aerobatic airplane. It's very floaty, looks very good, just kind of floating around doing some basic aerobatics, loops, figure eights, emblems, stuff like that. This airplane's going to be available late spring. It's going to hit the street for $329.99. And I'm not done with everybody yet. In addition to the Albatross, I'm here also to talk to you today about the new A6M50-300, one of the most famous airplanes of the war. These were actually used as kamikaze airplanes, so used widely by the Japanese Navy. There were several variants of it. This is one of the later variants, the more widely produced, the Model 5. So the airplane is constructed of all EPS foam, is all pre-painted at the factory, tails installed, everything's hinged. Similar to the P-40, if you remember, it's got a O-ring that attaches the wing to the fuselage, so it's very easy to get the airplane ready for flight. Motors installed, servos installed, linkage is done for you. So it's not quite like an ultra micro airplane where you can just pull it out of the box and install a battery and go, but you have to hook on the wing with an O-ring and bind it, and it is ready to go. So very, you know, you can have the airplane out of the box and in the air probably 15 minutes. You can see it's got a pretty high level of detail with it, a lot of very high quality graphics on the airplane. These are dry transfer decals, very similar to what you'll see with the Hawker Hurricane, which we'll be releasing here in the next week or so, actually. So we kind of have stepped it up with the new level of detail with the airplane. It features 3.5 gram digital servos that we developed for this airplane. Also a 300 size motor, same motor that was in the P-40 Warhawk that was installed. It's also got a 10 amp speed control that's installed. So literally pull it out of the box, stick the wing on it and go. It's going to be available same time frame as the Albatross, which is around late spring, street price of $149.99.
Thanks a lot, Ryan. I'm sure you guys will agree that Albatross is an absolutely gorgeous plane. And that little 300 size Zero that we have out there now from E-flite, that's going to be a blast out there. Perfect plane to go out, you know, whether you're at the flying field or at a larger park. It's just going to be a great plane to go out there and fly, especially if you've got that Warhawk out there too, do some aerial dogfight. Oh, that'd be really cool out there. Now, as you can see on the bench, we have another Albatross. This one here is coming to us from ParkZone, and Matt Andron was the man behind the SE-5A and also has been the one behind this Albatross here. There's a lot of great details, much like the E-flite version, that have gone into this. They've modeled the same engine. You have a pilot figure back here. Oh yeah, it's even got the little scarf that you can hear as it goes through the air. It's pretty sweet looking. We caught up with Matt to learn about the details on the Albatross from ParkZone.
Matt Andron with ParkZone here showing off the brand new ParkZone Albatross D5A. Last year we introduced the SE-5, and every allied airplane needs an adversary, so we brought out the Albatross. This airplane really captures the look of the Albatross. You know, it's a unique airplane with the wooden structure on the fuselage, and it just lends itself to doing this type of structure in foam. The airplane will be available in two different completion levels. As typical with the ParkZone airplanes, it'll be in a bind and fly and plug and play. The bind and fly is going to be about $250, and the plug and play will be about $185, just like you've seen with the SE-5. So, great companion for the SE-5. Really work well together and look great in the sky together. For transmitters, you know, this is a simple four-channel airplane, so you can use anything from a DX4E on up. You know, whatever you have all the way up to your 12X or higher. You know, the flight characteristics of this airplane are really friendly. Anybody who has the SE-5 knows that it really looks good in the air and is a very docile airplane. It has great characteristics, you know, no unfriendly habits, and this plane's no different. It flies extremely well. You got the really high visibility color scheme, which makes it great on, you know, those hazy days where something like the SE-5 being green can sometimes disappear in those tree lines. This airplane is actually modeled after the Red Baron trim scheme. So this was flown by Manfred von Richthofen. It was one of his not quite most popular airplanes, but very popular scheme of his. He actually liked the triplane a little bit better in terms of the way it flew. This airplane should be hitting the store shelves probably sometime late spring, so just keep an eye out for it and look for it out there. It'll be a great companion to the SE-5. And then one also little thing we threw in for you guys. Some of you may have noticed that there is a unique mount on the bottom of the SE-5. Well, there is the same mount on the bottom of this airplane, and we've actually set it up so that with the purchase of the Sonic Combat module and a little adapter that we're coming out with, a ParkZone adapter, you can now do Sonic Combat with the two World War I airplanes. So that should really add a lot of excitement to this airplane and the SE-5. Go out and have some dogfights at the local schoolyard. So this airplane comes set up with the typical power system that you come to expect in the SE-5. It's the 480 motor, E-flite 30 amp speed control, and ParkZone 1800 milliamp hour 3-cell LiPo. So exact same power system, about the same performance as you've seen from the SE-5A as well. And Gary mentioned something in the podcast and asked if the scarf made some noise when you go to full throttle, and it actually does. You can hear it fluttering on some of the passes. It gives that extra little realistic factor there, and seeing it flap in the breeze really makes this airplane fit the part. The other accessory that comes with this airplane is you'll see here it's equipped with a tail skid. We've actually had it set up so in the box you can either choose an optional tail wheel for operation off pavement or the tail skid for operation off grass.
Now we have a couple other items here on the bench to talk about. We're going to set the Albatross aside here for right now. The first one here, we're going to turn our attention to the guys from Blade because they have a new Blade 300X collective pitch. Yeah, no flybarless helicopter out there. I know a lot of people have been asking on our Facebook page, how about a flybarless 120SR? Well, we didn't come out with that, but we do have a 300X for you guys. We caught up with James Haley from Blade to learn all about the 300X.
Hi, I'm James Haley here with Horizon Hobby Product Development. We're here to talk to you about the Blade 300X. This is going to be a bind and fly only model. It's very similar in size to the Blade SR. We're belt driven with wood blades on it. You can use your DX6i, DX7, DX7S, or DX8. So any JR computer radio or a Spektrum computer radio will work on this. It does have the AR, the Spektrum AR 7200 included. It's built into the frames here, so you can, it's a very clean install. The way it flies is very light. It's extremely light disc loading for its size. So for a lot of the indoor fly-ins, a lot of the indoor environments, it's very comfortable and natural feeling. The tail is very, you know, rock solid being belt driven, so it gives you a lot of confidence in the model. The flight performance of the helicopter is very impressive for, you know, its size. Being belt driven, obviously it gives a very good tail feel on it, very locked in, so you can, you know, doing extreme maneuvers, tick-tocks, pirouetting, you know, piro flips, piro loops, it'll go right around, no problems. It has thrust bearings in the tail grips that keep the tail grips, you know, unloaded, so the tail performs really flawlessly. The dampening in the head is very solid, so you don't get any bobbles or anything like that on hard stops. Comes back to, you know, just really light feeling in the air that, you know, especially indoors, gives you a lot of confidence on how it flies. As you can see with the Spektrum AR 7200 with B-Stec technology, it's really stable in a hover, really locked in tail, no drifting or anything like that. Just gives you a lot of confidence in the model. This will be shipping in April, and at a price of $379.99. I think a lot of people will be really excited for it. It gives you just a you know, nice small machine to practice a lot of this stuff while still being able to fly outdoors on the own wind. So I think everybody will be happy about it.
Thanks a lot, James. And not to be outdone, the 300X was not the only heli that Blade debuted at Nuremberg. In fact, they had, well, I guess you would say three total helis, four different configurations. Along with the 300X, Blade also debuted the 500X and the 500 3D. Mikhail Graham is the man that has been working really hard to get both of those helis out. You know, two different configurations. You have a bind and fly, a ready to fly, and a bind and fly basic, depending on which of those helis you're talking about. But we stepped up and talked with Mikhail to find out all the performance ins and outs on the new 500 size helicopters from Blade.
Hello everyone, my name is Mikhail Graham. I am a Blade helicopter product developer here at Horizon Hobby. I am here to introduce to you Blade's new 500 class helicopter. We have here the 500X and the 500 3D. The 500X, as you can see here, is flybarless. It includes the AR7200BX. It will come as a bind and fly completion level, so it'll come with a 6S 2900 30C LiPo as well as a charger. Simply take your transmitter, bind it, you're ready to go. Then we have the Blade 500 3D. This will come in two completion levels, the ready to fly and the bind and fly basic. Now, recommended transmitter for the X, all you really need is a DX6i and above, but I would recommend a DX7S or a DX8 for the 500X. This will allow you some more flexibility in terms of programming and tuning the helicopter to your flying style. Also, it adds a lot of tunability in the 7200 that's included. For the 3D, as ready to fly, comes with the DX6i transmitter. And for the bind and fly basic, all you need is DX6i or above. Again, I would recommend DX7S, DX8. That'll give you everything you need and give you a bit more adjustability. Included accessories, the 500X comes with everything you would expect from a bind and fly completion level. Comes with the helicopter, the charger, the battery, and a few screwdrivers to allow you to take it apart and adjust the AR7200BX. Same thing with the 3D. Comes with the transmitter, charger, battery, and a few accessories for disassembly and reassembly. The bind and fly basic comes with the helicopter and the assembly tools. Now, let's talk a little bit about the flight characteristics. As I've stated before, this is flybarless, this is flybarred. The 500 3D is really geared towards the person who is stepping up from a 450 3D or stepping into a larger collective pitch helicopter. This is really geared towards the intermediate to advanced pilot. This is when, okay, if you already have a 450, you can step up to this. But let's say you're ready for the next step and you don't want to do the 450, you want to go straight to the big boy. The 3D, this is the machine to go to. Now, for those experienced pilots, for those who just want all-out raw performance, the 500X is the way to go. The 500X is the most powerful helicopter that Blade has put out. This is flybarless, and the power that it presents in the air is simply phenomenal. It takes full advantage of the AR7200, as well as just the benefits of it being flybarless. Now, just a few things about the helicopter themselves. Like I said, these are the Blade's largest helicopters, but they also have a few features. Namely, they come with carbon fiber blades as standard, and they also have carbon fiber frames as standard. Now, especially with the 500X and with both of these helicopters, 500X and the 500 3D, you have the convenience that they're built out of the box. All you need to do is install your main blades and you're ready to go. And there's no building, there's no setup. Outside of the bind and fly completion levels, you do have to set up your transmitter. But once you get the helicopter, put on your blades, you're ready to go. Now, we have an ETA set for this summer. And the price we have for the 500X, we have it's $899.99. And for the also 500X bind and fly. And then we have the 500 3D ready to fly. That is $849.99. And the 500 3D bind and fly basic, which is $599.99. Now, I've been flying both of these helicopters. Obviously, the 500X is my favorite. It is the most capable between the two. It's more powerful. And with the added performance provided by the AR7200BX with BeastX technology, the flight characteristics is phenomenal. You will not be disappointed by the performance that the 500X offers. Now, in contrast, is not to leave the 3D in the shadow. You know, for relaxing, you know, you just want to fly around, have a relaxing day, the 500 3D definitely delivers. You don't have to be on top of it as much as the X. It's a little bit more relaxing. It's not as intimidating. It's a very relaxing helicopter to fly in comparison. So between these two helicopters, depending on where you stand in your flight skills, pick your poison and go out and have a blast.
Thanks a lot, Mikel. Those are some really big and bad looking helicopters that you have out there. I can't wait to see you guys out there flying them, seeing what they can do, pushing them to the limits. Now, we have an update of a very popular product here from Losi. The 124 scale short course truck and rally cars have been out a little bit over a year now, and they've been really, really popular. But people have been asking for a version of these cars and trucks that come with 2.4 gigahertz DSM Spektrum technology and brushless motors and speed controllers in them. Losi has answered your call, and we have a new update to the short course truck, the 24 scale short course truck, and the rally car. I got to tell you, looking at the rally car wheels, those things are pretty hot. We caught up with Andy Ziegler from Losi to find out just what's all gone into these and how different they may be from the originals.
Thank you, Gary. Once again, thank you for having me. This week, we're here to talk about the 124 scale micro brushless rally and SCT. For those of you that know about our previous versions of these are kind of an evolution of the product. I'll cover some of the major differences of what those are. These things are pretty exciting. First of all, you notice in the name, brushless. So these things are coming out of the box with a brushless system. And ESC is capable of handling a 2S or 3S LiPo. If you want to upgrade to that, it has the automatic cutoff. But the vehicle itself comes with a 4S nickel metal hydride pack that's been standard with all of our 124 scale micro vehicles. You'll notice that the body is blue and silver. It comes in two different color schemes between the two. The blue and silver here, you switch that blue, silver for the truck. Same thing with the rally car. On the rally car, it's got a new set of wheels. They're a white spoke, pretty sporty looking wheel. Very cool indeed. Gives a little bit more scale detail and look to it. These vehicles are ready to run out of the box. Everything in the box is included to get you going. Another big feature change between these and the originals is the 2.4 gigahertz Spektrum DSM transmitter. No more need to pull out the long antenna and have a longer antenna sticking out of the vehicle. You got that convenience there, as well as the interference-free 2.4 operation. As far as parts compatibility between these versions and the original, pretty much all the parts and any hop-ups that are out there for the original brushed versions will fit right on here. Even if you want to take these cool new blue and silver bodies and put them on the old, you can. One thing that I forgot to mention about the ESC itself, it'll run a brushed motor if you don't want to run the brushless or change it out or whatever. We include the pigtail that goes from a 3-wire down to a 2-wire brushed motor operation, so you have that option to do as well. As far as an ETA goes, we're looking to have these in shops and on horizonhobby.com by the end of February with a price of $149.99.
Thanks a lot, Andy. Now, we also have two new releases before I leave you today from Hangar 9. The first is a Tiger Moth. Many of the brave who flew Spitfires and Hurricanes to victory in the Battle of Britain began their journey into the history books at the controls of a de Havilland Tiger Moth. The Hangar 9 Tiger Moth 20cc has brilliantly captured the spirit of the Tiger Moth with this outstanding giant scale model. Along with a near-perfect scale outline, it employs the use of the same under camber airfoil that made the full scale version such a joy to fly at slower speeds. Other scale touches include wire rigging, an accurately modeled undercarriage, instrument panel details, and much more. Next up from Hangar 9 is a brand new P-40B Warhawk 50. This unique recreation of the mighty P-40B is modeled after a couple of Warhawks flown by Lieutenants Ken Taylor and George Welsh during the attack on Pearl Harbor. Along with its authentic trim scheme and decals, usually only available on more expensive kits, the aircraft has been designed with low parts count, so assembly is quite simple. You even have the choice of prepping it with either glow or electric power. Hardware for either option is available. In the air, the Warhawk not only captures that look and feel of the originals from back in the World War II era, these are just great flying sport airplanes too. You guys are going to have a blast flying these at your local flying field. Finally this week, we have some new updates on the DX-10T and some new technology and features coming from the folks over at Spektrum. We visited with Matt McCarty to talk about the new X Plus line of receivers and some of the accessories.
Thanks, Gary. And well, here today I got the new lineup of X Plus that we're featuring to you. We have a addition of three receivers in the receiver line, and then of course the X Plus 8 module, which will expand upon 8 more channels when using an X Plus compatible transmitter like the DX-10T, which is currently shipping in Germany as of today. So to kind of highlight the receiver lineup, I'll start off with our higher end receiver here. We have the AR12-120. You can see it's a power safe receiver, 12 channels. And the neat thing about the X Plus receivers, you'll notice, is the SRXL port, which is how we link into the X Plus 8. So the customer doesn't need to use a power safe receiver. You just need a standard 12 channel receiver where you can power through, say, a dual battery lead. You don't need the EC3 connectors. We offer the 12020 12 channel DSMX X Plus receiver. And this can be applicable to any giant scale aerobatic planes, scale warbirds, jets, any type of application. You need 12 channels or 10 plus 8 in this case. The newest addition here for our 9 channel lineup, we're replacing the 9020 DSMX receiver with the, I'm sorry, we're replacing the 9010 receiver with the 9020, which adds the X Plus feature. And you can see here the SRXL actually hooked up to the X Plus module. So the way this works is you have SRXL on both units. You connect them with a male-to-male lead, which we also offer additional lengths and leads up to 24 inches so that you can place the X Plus module in different portions of your aircraft. This lead must always be hooked up. Something that's kind of cool that we offer with the X Plus, since you're powering, it could be one servo additional or it could be 8 additional servos. We offer the option of using this jumper, which pulls power off the receiver, or you can disconnect the jumper and we offer 2 battery ports to power with external power. The new X Plus receiver lineup is currently compatible with the DX10T and any future high-end Spektrum radio that offers the X Plus is branded with the X Plus branding. And currently the DX7S, DX8, they will not be X Plus compatible. And you can look at the new receiver lineup. We're looking at the end of the winter.
Man, oh man, we had a ton of stuff to go over this week. No tips and tricks for you this week. We'll come back with that in 2 weeks' time. We just had so much other stuff to go with. We just didn't want the show to go on longer than it needed to. But man, from the new, the 300X, this Firebird Stratos is really cool. I can't wait to get my hands on the controls on one of these and take it up in the air and fly. Just having known the time, effort, and attention to detail that Kike has put into this, you guys are going to love it out there. From the Westward sailboat, the new updates to the 124 scale micro vehicles from Losi, the 2 different albatrosses, the jet, ultra micro EDF MiG. Wow. These guys have really hit home runs, and I just wanted to say thank you for everyone for helping out with this episode of On the Horizon. As you guys can tell, a lot of stuff to talk about and a lot of different people to talk to. So thanks everyone who did have a hand in helping out with this week's episode. Again, did want to remind everyone too, make sure if you've got a plane you want to show off, a helicopter, car, truck, boat, whatever, and you want to share it with the world and want to have it seen here on the Horizon, make sure that you email us at editors@horizonrc.com and we'll go ahead and we'll show everybody what you guys are working on out there, even if it's just a project that you haven't completed yet and you want to share with the world. Some final updates for you this week. Make sure that you check out our build threads and the new forums that we've added to our Facebook page, facebook.com/horizonhobby. If you look over on the left-hand side, there's a new forums tab there. And John Redman has been working hard with the build. I've had my build of the Team Losi Racing 22T is found there. You've even seen some of our fans that have started their own build thread. So very cool way to interact with all of you guys and gals out there. That will do it for us this week. We will see you in 2 weeks' time. Make sure that you go back if you're looking for more information on the Ultra Micro MiG from E-flite. Check out last week's RC cast. And in the meantime, take care and have some fun with hobbies.